Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Use Lagrange Mean Value Theorem to show that cos of ax minus cos of bx is a whole divided by x absolute is less than or equal to b minus a absolute if x is not equal to 0. Consider the function f of t is equal to cos of t. This function is a trigonometric function, and trigonometric function is continuous everywhere. Therefore, the trigonometric function f of t is equal to cos of t is also continuous on the closed interval whose endpoints are ax and bx, which is a subset of the set of real number. Therefore, the first condition of Lagrange mean value theorem is satisfied. To check the second condition of Lagrange mean value theorem, differentiate the function f of t is equal to cos of t with respect to t, which is equal to d divided by dt of f of t is equal to d divided by dt of cos of t. The derivative of cos of t is equal to minus sine of t multiplied by the derivative of t with respect to t, where t is the angle, which is equal to minus sine of t multiplied by the derivative of t with respect to t is equal to 1. 1 multiplied by minus sine of t is equal to minus sine of t. And the result of the derivative of the given function is not equal to plus or minus infinity for t belong to the open interval whose endpoints are ax and bx, which is a subset of the set of real number, because the range set of sine of t is a closed interval from minus 1 to 1 for each t belong to the real number. Therefore, the derivative of the function is not equal to plus or minus infinity for t belong to the open interval whose endpoints are ax and bx, which is a subset of the set of real number. That is, the function f of t is differentiable on the open interval a whose endpoints are ax and bx. That is, the second condition of Lagrange mean value theorem is satisfied. Therefore, according to the Lagrange mean value theorem, there exists a point C contained in the open interval whose endpoints are ax and bx, such that the slope of the chord passing through the endpoints of the given curve is equal to the tangent line at a point C parallel to the chord passing through the endpoints of the given interval. That is, f of b minus f of bx minus f of ax is a whole divided by bx minus ax, this is the length of the given interval, is equal to the derivative of the function at point C. The derivative of the function is equal to minus sine of t at a point C. The derivative of the function is equal to minus sine of C, which is equal to minus sine of C is equal to f of t is equal to the function is the given function is f of t is equal to cos of t. Therefore, f of bx is equal to cos of bx minus f of ax is equal to cos of ax is a whole divided by bx minus ax, and x is common, which is equal to x multiplied by b minus a is equal to minus sine of c. Multiply both sides by b minus a, which is equal to cos of bx minus cos of ax is a whole divided by x is equal to minus b minus a sine of c. Taking absolute of both sides, we have cos of bx minus cos of ax is a whole divided by x absolute is equal to minus b minus a multiplied by sine of c absolute. According to the absolute property, minus b minus 1 multiplied by b minus a absolute is equal to b minus a absolute multiplied by sine of c absolute. And the range of sine of C is the closed interval from minus 1 to 1. Therefore, the absolute of sine of C is less than or equal to 1, which is equal to B minus A absolute is less than or equal to B minus A absolute multiplied by 1. After the simplification, the result is equal to cos of bx minus cos of ax is a whole divided by x absolute is less than or equal to b minus a absolute multiplied by 1 is equal to b minus a absolute, which is required.